camera turned off. Before we lift this up in the air, show you some things we noticed right off the bat. Yeah, you know, they put seam sealer on this. There's some damage on the weather stripping here. You know, this was maybe a reused retainer, which water could be getting into there. But yeah, this was all seam sealed because the rear panel was replaced. It was attached to the original taillight pocket, original quarter. You can even see this, you know, there's some openings in this. There's that cross-threaded bolt that was on that stay, obviously full of water. We got the flashlight. We're gonna lift this vehicle up, kind of show some differences. You know, we could definitely see a difference of where they did the seam seal work. Where, you know, still some exposed welds, metal is on this. In cases of, like, for right there, some Bondo or seam seal going through a hole. Now I'm doing this. Little things like, this doesn't even look like it's, well, this is broken. So that needs a new piece. These little cable retention clips are not in place right. Let's see if this one's broken. No, this one's fine. But we're gonna go look at this thing. Inside and out, you can tell the rear body panel has changed. You know, what we're looking for is holes like that. You know, missed welds like there, not fully on the rear taillight pocket. Still exposed holes, big gaps. The shop used a spot welder. And it's like there's some kind of panel bond used there, hopefully, not just seam sealer. And then again, we saw those exposed welds right there. You can see it's already starting to rust. Floor was changed, and also the frame rail was changed. See some repairs that were done on this floor support. Kind of some holes in the welds in the metal there. You compare this side, compare that side, you know, huge difference. Actually, shoot, there's still metal shavings in this car. Metal shavings there. It's nowhere near properly cleaned out. Old bump stop. Reused. Looks like we got some tape still here. So that's the trunk. Now, we're gonna lift up the car too. Some of the things we notice on the outside is, obviously we have panel separation here. Big old separation in that area right here. We got
panel separation there.
Exposed metal on the old wheel well all the way down to the bottom. Some fuel line clips aren't in the right place.
Look on this side of the wheel well.
Like grinding marks in a couple areas. Looks like, again, exposed weld right there. There, there, there. So in a lot of areas.
Okay, that's the wheel well.
We're gonna look on the inside. So we can tell they sectioned it. Somewhere right here. Again, you know, you could tell where
before work was done. Grind marks, you see where it's welded, you can see the grind marks through the refinish. You know, that wasn't properly sealed and prepped. Go all the way up.
And we know the section line was somewhere here. It looks like they cut into the inner structure. Grinding on the inner structure. It looks like there's overspray in the inner wire harness. Airbag sensor is right here. The airbag sensor doesn't even look like it's been removed because there is red overspray paint on it. Spots. Again, to the inside, whole inner support was changed. All this was overlapped for some reason to up there. And this was coated all the way to here. So again, this is what bothers me about the door panel. I have no idea why those are damaged like that. You can see the door bolts have been removed, they've been scarred, and the upper hinge has that damage also.
We're going to notice a lot of openings in this panel. Get a better shot of it. It's like there. But I don't know what kind of seam sealer was used on this, but it is flaking off. If I could do that with my fingernail, I don't know how well that watertight that is. But we have some issues with this rear mounting on this. You can see its threads are not going in that straight. And we have some serious seam sealer issues. I don't know what kind they use, but that definitely doesn't look OEM approved. And it is cracking everywhere. Compare this side. To this side. Alright, smoothed out. Nice and clean. Sealed. You know, no gaps. That seam sealed all the way. Nice and solid. Retainer's broken for the fuel assembly. Hose retainers. Seam sealer and repairs of some type were done all the way to this inner lower structure, all the way to here, where you can see grind marks still. see in there. Body plugs are missing. This poor weld, welds weren't really taken care of and treated that well there. All right, we'll look inside this panel, see what we find.
have is pretty much from about where the suspension starts forward is tabulated. Everything from very back of spring drill to about suspension, dry as a bone, and you can see some exposed welds again. And we're running into an issue where, of course, raw metal, they get to this again, will have devastating effects, because since that floor is already full of water, you can only imagine what this is going to do. There you go. And then, so if we look in here, you can see this greasy substance in the front, which is over there. But back here, if you look at this thing, you can see straight grind marks. No, any kind of, so drop my phone. No protection at all. You can see there's that weld burnt and resting right there. We're gonna look in this raw through here. See what we can find. Oh. Looks like someone's already poked a hole right there. Must be for cavity wax. At least we hope it is. Oh, jeez. At least you hope they did cavity wax. Because if they did, they didn't use a long enough wand. So, right here in the rocker, you can see that's raw. Oop, get back to it. Burnt weld. And there's no coating on that at all. Another one, there's more back there. Get back tone to it. talking this area right here. We're having that issue. Let's go ahead and check this. Area here. Gotta go down with the car a little more. That looks like a buckle. This all looks buckled to me right here. Hard to tell on the camera, but man, that shouldn't look like that. Also, see they welded this extension on. Imagine that. No corrosion protection. Get this turned up a little more. Raw weld. Raw weld. So that's all this right here. There's a sail panel. Raw welds, burnt. Looks like overlapped. About to check the guidelines, see if they're supposed to allow overlap. That is right there. Right in there. You got even intel paint adhesions on the inside, so. This is definitely a candidate for a improper repair procedures and guidelines not fully followed. It's what we preach here at Coachworks. You know, using the right kind of seam sealers. It's the reason why they cost $40, $50. So they don't break down. And then, again, following OEM procedures, because here we go. Your inside of your panel is not supposed to look like that. And again, I'm gonna have to check Toyota to see if they
allow a overlap like that. Looks like there's one. A backing plate was used. Even the back plate was used. It was not cleaned up and not properly. Coated with corrosion protection. So, I've seen the old sleeve right here. That goes all the way down the sail panel. Wow. Okay. Well. That's my video of this Toyota Corolla.